boys, hey girls. We're gonna do some hamburgers on the grill today. And I had a little buddy stop by here and say hi, D. What, you sleep? Wake up, boy. He don't want to talk right now. Maybe we can persuade him. Yeah, we go take his beer. See, he been drinking my beer. Non-union, but I tell you the truth. So we're gonna go grill some beers, and you want another beer, D2? Huh? Want one? Yeah, them beers are for you. All right, so we'll go ahead and proceed. Simple hamburgers grilled on a grill. Barbecue grill, boy. Come on, come on, come on. Okay. You ain't getting none, no. Why? Because you're drinking all the beer, you know? Told you he was non-union. So, D-boy, I don't want to hear about you getting too drunk either. I don't want to see no oil on the damn ground. I'll get my sonic blast out and knock your ass off. Okay, I wanted to show y'all this. I cut a little piece of pipe like this to fit across my grill. And I got one of those, how you call that, burner protectors that's supposed to go on. It is made of stainless. It's supposed to go on your electric cooktop, a gas cooktop, to keep splatters from getting down up inside the burner. And I put some mosquito repellent wood on there. And then we're going to light the burner. And then I'm going to take this sizzle cue that happens to fit my grill. They sell them in different sizes. And let's see, can I get it in here one-handed? They're heavy. Made of stainless. So it fits down in there, and it's kind of cockeyed, but there you go. So now you got a griddle to cook on, and underneath that you're going to have smoke coming out, and the griddle going to get hot. And a griddle makes an excellent burger. It makes a good crust on your burger, and you can put eggs on here and bacon and whatever the hell else you want to put on there. And it just does a good job. You can't put eggs on the grate, okay? But you can put it on a griddle. And so that's what we're going to use. And they got a little grease drip tray right down there to catch the grease. Boy. Shut up, robot. Just drink the beer and shut up. I got some ground chuck, and this is preferred, or any 80-20 beef. You can actually blend your own ground chuck with brisket or rib meat, and it makes an excellent, excellent steakhouse-type burger. If you use less than 20% fat, your burgers are most likely going to come out dry unless you cook them rare. And unless you ground the beef yourself, you don't want to cook it rare. Trust me. And I ain't ground that. I just wash my hands in the sink till they squeaky clean. And I got me a lashpa patata pan. Yeah, that's the worry. Put you some salt down on that. So when you put your burgers on there, that side gonna be salted. And put some pepper on there. I know I told y'all all this before. I'm gonna tell you again, damn it. Now let's form some patties. Keep your hands wet while you're doing that. And we're gonna make us 8 little patties. patty cake. What he said. Yeah, the beers are for you, stupid. And you know, I mean, it's some bitch that drank now. All right, so we got these eight little patties formed up, and we're gonna mash them. No shit, huh? Mash them down. And don't overwork the meat. If you overwork it, you're gonna end up with a sausage. You don't wanna do that. So just mash your patties down and leave them the hell alone. Go grill them. And what we are gonna do is stick these in the freezer and let them firm up just a bit. Beat that burger patty down in there. We're gonna let them firm up a bit. That'll make it easier to handle when we're dealing outside on the grill, on the Barbie coast. Boy, I'm gonna season this top side too, yeah. But you worry about that salt and pepper. That's what I like. You put what the hell you want on it. Oh yeah, make you an indention inside of each burger. Like that, make it convex or concave, yeah, something like that. That way, when it shrinks up, it'll be more uniform in shape, okay? So do that on all of them. Now let's season the other side. Good. Wow, we've got the camera rolling. You rolling? Good. We're gonna indention all of them. Season these heavily with salt, if that's all you're gonna put. If you want garlic powder, do all that shit. I would suggest you don't mix in seasonings. That's gonna make this burger more sausage-like. It'd be like making kofta. Trust me. And I like kofta. But I also like plain, stupid-proof burgers. Put that in the freezer for about 15, 20, 30 minutes, drink some beer, and entertain your guest. See him over there? I ain't bringing you no more beer. That's tough. So, can you make lamb burgers? Oh, hell yeah. How about all ground pork burgers? Damn right, I need to do that. I've seen some videos that did that. And I'd like to try it. I want beef. I like beef. Give me some damn beef. So that's what we're doing. Beef burgers. Simple, plain, simple. Stupid. Keep it simple, stupid. I like that rule. That's what I'm gonna do. Drink beer, grill some burgers, maybe throw some cheese on top of the bun. Ooh. Why would you do that? Cheeseburger uncovered. Like that. So we got our wood fired up just a little too much down there. Let's pour some beer on there. Y'all cool down. And that was mosquito repellent wood. And we got some chopped steak parts that have been partially frozen so you can handle them. How about that? Look over here, boy. Put them right on the griddle. See, like that? Gotta get one more on there, JB. Come on, get him. Get him on there. Good. Him's on there. I got some corn on the cob. Can you griddle them too? Hell yeah. Just put them on there. Let them griddle up. Be like elote, Mexican grilled corn. griddle corn, street food. And you brush it down with mayonnaise and sour cream and chili peppers and salt and peppers and what else goes on there? Lime juice. Yum. We're just going to have it straight griddled like that. Just like they do down there in Tijuana. I'm going to tell y'all this one last time. Don't mash down on them burgers. You're squeezing out all the juice. Release them from the grill and flip them over. Look at the crust. That's flavor right there. See right there? There's your flavor. Big time. I see that side's running a little hotter, but that's where the wood was. It's burning up underneath these. Oh, let's see how them little corns are coming. They're coming just fine. Cooking in that the grease from the damn burgers. What they cooking in? You want butter, put butter. You don't need all that bullshit. See how this one looks? See, it wasn't ready to flip yet. Right? We'll deal with it. And you make you a Diablo sandwich with all this, huh? Oh, hell yeah. Pause, stupid. Pause. So how do we make this better? Well, flip your burgers. The indention I made on them. Y'all go over on that side. Okay. Cheeseburger. Now, one cheeseburger. Two cheeseburger. Let's grill some onions. Like that. Let's put some garlic right inside them onions. What's that for? That's for me, boy. Don't you worry about it. Let's take grease ring and put a cackle fruit down in there. Now, how you want to act? Get you one of them little pieces of garlic and put it in there too. Look down there. See in there? Garlic, egg, cheeseburger. Rotate your corns. See like that there? Cooking is easy. Put you some more onions on there. Or grill some onions. Chunk them on there. How about that? Could you put some bacon on here? Yeah, if you had grill room. Maybe we'll do that too. We'll pull them burgers off. Let them rest. That's a barbecue term. In the oven. Stick a slice of bacon on there. Bacon, eggs, corn. Yum. Cheeseburger. Burger. With piece of cheese. Burger, piece of cheese. Burger, piece of cheese. Cheeseburger. non-cheeseburger. Burger. Grill onion burger. You like that? How about grilled garlic onion burger? Yum. While you're at it, drop you a piece of onion down in that bacon that's cooking. Yum. And play with these across the grill. The griddle. You like that? But don't y'all understand? This is easy and simple. I'm gonna go drink another beer. And put the cheeseburger in the oven to keep warm. Yum. So we got a burger with cheese on top. And we got some bacon that we can put on top too. Ooh, cool, huh? Let's get a burger and build a better cheeseburger. Better, better. Stronger, faster. So I think I'm gonna take this little slider burger right here. It's got onion on the bottom. See down in that? And get this fried cackle fruit with garlic and onion on it. Y'all come up on top. Yum. And let's get us a little piece of corn on the cob. And some bacon. You want more bacon, you put all that shit on there. All right. Another piece of bacon. Now, you want more? Look over there. Look over there. Put your toppings on there. Don't put no ketchup on the son of a bitch. You want tomato? Put tomato. Don't put no damn ketchup on a burger. Come on, man. This ain't Burger King. You don't get it your way, and if you don't take it my way, you don't get the son of a bitch. Now, let's get us a little bit of pickle. Let's get a slice of tomato. Like that. Let's get us some mayo, because I like it on my burger. I really do. See, and rub it all in. Yeah. Mayo in the mouth. Let's get us some mustard. And I happen to have some German mustard. Yum. Take a few stills before I go eat, because I'm hungry. So you can go to Little Griddle Inc. online and get one of these griddles. Look at that dumb dog hovering. It wants some burger. It ain't getting none though. And get you the sizzle cue. Like I said in the video, it's available in different models. I've also seen them at Sam's Club. And you can griddle anything you want on a son of a bitch. I mean, vegetables. And was this burger good? Duh. Yes, it was. And the day before this, I made a pizza. And I used, I bought it for my daughter who likes to make quick pizzas for lunch. But she never used the mix because it was just too much. It was Jiffy brand mix, pizza crust mix. And I tightened it up with, look at that cheese on top of that bun, yum. I tightened it up with some olive oil, about a heaping teaspoon of olive oil, and some garlic powder, and a little bit of oregano like I do in my homemade pizza crust. And it come out good. It come out real good. And I put all kind of stuff on it. Just, what all did I put on that? Burger, and I think I had some pepperonis, and I don't remember. And I baked it a little bit longer than the box directions call for. And it was great. The crust was crispy. It was a thin crust. And I just did it in a pan. I greased the pan first and salted and peppered some tomatoes and chunked them on there, and onions and garlics and the seasoned burger, and yum, yum, yum. That's all I can say. I ate the whole damn pie. Yep. Cool, huh?